Hi, I'm Patricia Bleckman with KE2 Therm. The launch of the KE2 LDA communication device has created a means to access the KE2 Low Temp's webpage and remotely monitor the system, adjust controller set points, and receive alarm notifications via text or email. So let's take a look at the KE2 Low Temp's webpage and see what we have. You should have already installed the KE2 LDA on your network, and your KE2 Low Temp is wired to the KE2 LDA. We have other videos and literature that address this, so I won't go into detail here. The KE2 LDA dashboard will automatically populate with the first 10 KE2 Therm controllers it sees on the network. To access the KE2 LDA dashboard, connect your PC, tablet, or smartphone on the same network as the KE2 LDA. Then in your web browser's address bar, enter the IP address from the back label. This brings us to the KE2 LDA dashboard. We have a video that looks at the dashboard and management console if you want to take a closer look. But for this video, let's just go down the list and find a KE2 Low Temp controller. We click on that device, and here we are in the KE2 Low Temp's webpage. At the top, we see the user-defined name for the controller, then the KE2 Therm controller type, and then a button for Simple View. Simple View is used primarily for mobile devices and only displays the current room temperature. Clicking on Show Advanced View gives more information, which you see right here. And just as the name implies, the current system states are shown. They are System Mode, which here is refrigerate, then the current room temperature, coil temperature, the compressor relay, fan relay, defrost relay, auxiliary input 3, and auxiliary input 4. The auxiliary inputs can be configured for several uses. We'll look at that in a bit. And then last but not least, the alarm status. Below this, we have manual system control, which forces the controller to the next system mode. They are off, refrigerate, defrost, drain, and fan relay. Then we get to the set point section where you can make adjustments. Clicking the question mark reveals a blue area with the set point details. Here for the room temperature, we see the limits, a min and max temperature, and below that in gray, we see the current setting. We can scan across the row and see air temp differential, auxiliary temp 3, and here you see available options to be used. Aux temp 3 state, and auxiliary temp 4. And again, the list of options, which is the same as auxiliary temp 3. Auxiliary temp 4, compressor starts for hour. Then we see our defrost set points. Defrost pump down time, defrost time, defrost term on temp, defrost type, defrost per day, and then next is drain time, then fan delay temp, and fan state during defrost. High temp alarm offset, and high and low alarm delay. Low temp alarm offset, max fan delay time and mod rest address, refrigeration fan mode, and second room temp set point. While all of these points and manual operations can be managed from the front of the controller, the web page is quicker and easier, and you don't have to physically be with the controller. This brings us to the last section of the web page, which shows the device info, the firmware version, Modbus address, timeout counter, the device name, and this is where you provide the name that displays in the bar at the top of the page. Then firmware ID, which for KE2 Low Temps is always 20904, and then the KE2 Therm controller designation. Also, I want to mention that setting up alarm notifications for the KE2 Low Temp is done on the KE2 LDA's management console. The web pages for the other serial controllers are formatted the same. Here's the KE2 Temp Plus Valve, the KE2 Temp, and the KE2 Adaptive Control web pages. We have videos that look more closely at these web pages, and we have a series that looks at each page of the KE2 Evap's web pages. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for notifications of our latest video releases. If you'd like more information on our website, we have a bulletin which shows the webpage view for the serial devices, or you can contact our tech support line.